Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again. We're going to do a little different kind of a tutorial today. My boat motor has been sitting for a couple of years. And it'll fire up on ether. It'll fire up on carburetor cleaner. It just will not stay running. And that means the jets in that carburetor are clogged up and won't let the fuel continue through them. So what we've got to do is clean those jets out. Now we can tear that carburetor all apart, or maybe we can figure out an easier way to do it. First thing we got to do is get a look. Here's the carburetor back here. Is behind this plate. Boat motor carburetors are a little bit different kind of animal. So if you can avoid taking this carburetor apart, by all means, let's try to do that. So I'm going to show you how to flush these jets out without tearing that carburetor apart and hopefully get your boat motor on the lake and ready to go. Okay, let's start out with some very basic stuff about this old two-stroke motor. First of all, it gets its oil through the gasoline. So we don't want to use too much carburetor cleaner or too much ether to try to start this. Otherwise, we're going to dry out the bearings and we're going to dry out the rings, cause serious damage to the engine. That's very important. So much better to try to start this with a product like Deep Creep made by Seafoam that has oil already in it and is really good for starting these kind of motors. Second thing we have to remember about this is that it's water cooled. So we have to make sure there's some source of water to the lower end of the engine so that it can pull water up and cool itself after it starts. Otherwise it will overheat very, very quickly. We don't want either of those two situations to occur. Now, one other thing on top of that is this one's hanging on my boat. And there's a possibility of fuel getting in the boat. This happens to be an aluminum boat. You want to make sure if you get fuel leaked into your boat, that the boat is able to take it and that you have a sufficient way to drain it off. It is absolutely a fire hazard. So having said all that, we're going to continue. Okay, a lot of these older motors have fuel mixture adjustments right here on the front. And the outside one, your high speed mixture, can be unscrewed all the way out, and when you do, it will drain the fuel bowl into the boat. So if you want to catch this fluid, you would want to put some kind of container here. You just pull that out and there comes the nastiness. Okay, that was some pretty dark brown, ugly looking stuff. Now also over here on the side, let's put that down. There's a glass fuel bowl. You can see into the glass fuel bowl. You may want to also loosen the little nut up, dump it out, and put it back on. Mine happens to be pretty clear. Now I'm going to screw this jet back in again, all the way down until it seats carefully. We don't want to overseat it. And then I'm going to back it out 1.5 turns. Now that's just a starting point. We're probably going to have to change that as we go along. But if anything, I want it to start out a little rich so it's got a little extra oil to keep it lubricated. So we go half, one, 1.5 turns. Okay. The other mixture adjustment is a low speed mixture adjustment. And you can see it moves the upper jet here. Alright. Now, there's a rod in this upper jet. If we remove that rod, and this plastic is very old, but then I could unscrew that and take it out. But this boat motor is quite old, and I'm afraid removing some of this plastic might not be the best idea at this point. So unless I need to, I'm not going to take that apart. But as you can see, there's a splash shield here in front of the carburetor. You can't get back to it. So I'm going to take these two screws out of here and manipulate the choke, which is down here, and such, so that I can actually see inside the front of the carburetor. I removed the little cotter pin and pin that held the choke lever and pulled it out. That allowed me to remove that entire aluminum plate. Now the next thing I want to do with this upper adjustment is I want to screw it in and count the number of turns. So it's pretty hard to count a brass rod unless you make a scratch on it. So I'm going to scratch the top of it with my screwdriver. It makes a nice line for me to follow. And then we're going to screw it in to the bottom. Not so easy to screw with my fingers. You may have to use a pair of pliers. Once again, be very careful. You don't want to bottom it out and crack the seat. Okay, it actually went in about 3/4 of a turn. So we're going to count that as 3/4 of a turn. We're going to take it out completely, just like we did the lower one a minute ago. This will turn a lot easier if you loosen this packing nut here, because what it does is it squeezes on a washer that goes around the nozzle or the jet. Oh, needle valve in this case. And now I can turn it with my fingers. Until it comes all the way out. And we're going to look at that, and we're going to see that it's all covered with carbon. We want to clean that off with carburetor cleaner. And we're going to take our nozzle from our carburetor cleaner and spray it right in that hole. And I'm going to take the bottom one back out again and spray it in that hole. Okay, right inside here. And right inside there. You want to keep your can upright, otherwise all you're doing is spraying in air. We want to get some fuel to go through there. Blow a little bit in there and let her sit and drain for a minute or two. Now since I'm hooked up to my gas tank, I'm going to squeeze my gas bulb just a tiny little bit here, thus forcing some regular fuel to go in past the carburetor and push the carburetor cleaner out of the bowl, as I really don't want to use that concentrated a batch of carburetor cleaner to start this engine. Okay, there are two other holes I'm going to squirt. This one here and that one there. These have threads in them. We're not going to shoot them. You're going to find, if you look down inside of the carburetor itself and were to open the throttle up, you might see some other holes, but you cannot really get at those from out here without tearing it apart. What we're trying to do is avoid tearing it apart. So I will squirt some in this hole and this hole, and what those two holes are kind of like barometric pressure releases, so that the fuel bowl doesn't get pressurized by the engine pressure or heat or anything like that. And sometimes even a little fuel will squirt out of these holes and it'll be sucked back in by the carburetor. So we want to keep them clean at the same time. So we're going to spray in here, we're going to spray in here, and these two holes here. And hopefully that will do most of the job for us. Hey, when cleaning your needle valve, I do not recommend using sandpaper or anything really highly abrasive on it. We don't want to scratch it and we don't want to change its angle. So all I did was just rub it on a nylon strap here on my boat, and that was enough to clean it down sufficiently where we want it. Now we'll just put it back in its hole and screw it in all the way and back it out that same 3/4 turn where we were before. Okay, now the next step is a little more hairy perhaps. I want to turn the throttle position on your motor all the way to stop. Okay, that way the spark cannot spark. And now this is just a pull start motor. I don't have electric start on here. And what I want to do is I want to cover these holes up as best I can, and I may have to remove this nozzle again. And I'm just going to pull the engine a couple times. And what that does is it pulls fuel up through the jets forcefully, more forcefully than it would normally pull them up if it was trying to start. Make sure the carburetor is good and full of fuel. If you don't feel comfortable doing this, don't do it. Okay, we're full. Now you think you could do that with a choke, but it doesn't seal as well as your bare hand does. Okay, now you've got to install the parts back the way they were and get ready to fire up your engine. Nah, heck of a time for the video camera to go on the fritz. Needless to say, I put it all back together, shot it with a little bit of starter fluid, fired it up, and it ran fine. So if you follow those simple steps, usually that's all it takes to get you running again for the next year. This is Kevin Bacon. Thanks for watching.